All right, welcome back, guys. Today I'm going to be doing my most popular video that I've done, and it was the queso Mexican tacos. That was pastor. Today we're doing carne asada, but with all the fixings. Last video I didn't use all cilantro and onions and all that good stuff. Today we are, the cheese we're using today is a little bit different. We're using Chihuahua authentic Mexican style quesadilla cheese for melting. So this cheese I think is going to be top notch for these tacos. That's what we're gonna be using today for these. And once again, the carne, I went to the Mexican meat market, bought the carne asada they have already cut for tacos. That's what I have right here, ready to roll. I'm just gonna add my own seasoning this time. All right, let's go ahead and fire up this Blackstone. All right, now that our Blackstone is ready, just go ahead and add some oil. Let's add this meat in here. Let's add our Johnny's seasoning. Now, what's nice about going to a Mexican meat market is that they have this meat already cut in little tiny pieces for tacos, specially made for tacos. And it's a time saver. If they have this and you just buy it, you don't have to cut it no more. Pretty much what you guys are looking for is once the meat turns gray, all the meat is gray, then it's good to go. And for me personally, I like to move the meat around because then I'll get cool on this side, then I move it on the hotter side. And the beauty of this cook is it's really simple to make. It's not that hard and it's not time consuming either. And you can make a lot and feed a lot of people with this. Okay, now the meat is almost there. I'm gonna go on low, medium low. I had it on high the whole time, but I don't wanna burn the, it's almost time for the tortillas, and I don't wanna be on high for those. I wanna do more of a medium. What you wanna do now is now you wanna see if you're good on your seasoning. So I added some in the beginning, but sometimes you need a little bit more. So I'm just gonna grab a little tiny piece. Grab a little tiny piece. I think I need a little dab. Almost there. Just a little dab more. So now that you taste it, now you know how much more you need to add. So don't try to add all of it at the beginning because you don't want to make it too salty, then you mess it up. You add a little bit, wait till it's ready to taste, then you can add more. If you want. So this meat looks like it's ready for me to start the next process. So while this continues to cook, I'm gonna put it to the side and let it finish cooking while I get the tortilla and the cheese melting. So what we're gonna do is, the tortillas of choice are the yellow corn tortillas, my favorite. If you guys haven't tried it, give it a try. These yellow corns are really delicious. So we're gonna add some oil. And I'm going to cook them on one side and then flip them and then add the cheese. Okay, let's add our cheese. Okay, once the cheese is there, you can go ahead and add the meat right off the bat. Okay, I think we're satisfied with the amount of meat on each one. Okay guys, now we're gonna add our cilantro, onions. However much you guys want. Just like that. We're gonna add our cilantro. We're gonna add a homemade salsa. Oh, yes. Yes. Just like that. Now we close them. And now they're closed. That's how we have them. These are already ready. Look at that. Let's give them a try. All right, guys, we are done. These look good. Oh my God, they're smelling so good. And I know, ooh, with all the fixings in them, the salsa, the homemade salsa, it'll get just a nice touch to them. Now we give these a try. Wow. You can see that cheese. Make sure you guys try this. You will not disappoint it. Not be disappointed. Make sure you check out these videos. I'll see you guys next time.